So I'm here with Mike Mendoza. The newspaper show is back, Mike. I know you've been working on that for a number of years now, haven't you? So what can we expect from the new newspaper show?
Well, the new newspaper show is very different because it's you and me, the two of us together. We'll be looking at the headlines in both the national papers and the local papers, but we'll go behind some of the headlines as well. We've got some interesting stories coming up, and it'll be on every week at the same time.
Exactly. And people should check the schedule for that as well. But it's important, isn't it, to kind of for newspapers to still have a prominent role in our lives, in national life, really. They still lead the news agendas, newspapers. I know the internet's come of age and that very much drives news forward. But would you say that the newspapers still drive the major headlines?
No, because I don't think a lot of people take a lot of notice these days of newspapers. Right. Local newspapers are going by the way. I was shocked when I saw the Herald this week, because you've got the Shoreham Herald, you've got the Worthing Herald, and you've got the Lancing Herald, and you've got the Southwick Herald. From this week, it's now the Worthing Herald incorporating Shoreham, Southwick, and it's got to be the worst newspaper I think I've ever seen. Seeing as how there's meant to be four different areas in one paper, it should be a really thick and good paper. There was nothing in it. There was no news. It was absolutely awful. Whether they've got rid of all their journalists, I don't know. The Argus, for a long time now, has been running on 5 or 6 pages of news. They seem to have got rid of nearly all their journalists. They only seem to have 2 journalists working there now. They've got rid of their offices. This is going to be the problem with virtually every newspaper around the country, not just the nationals, but every local paper who rely on their advertising, and that is their income, is their advertising. Yeah. Now, to pay £1 or £1.50 for 5 or 6 pieces of paper is a lot of money if you're going to buy a paper every day.
Yeah, and news is an expensive business, isn't it? I mean, we're in the news business as well, and we know for a fact it's very expensive, isn't it? And do you think you should get more government support then? Because we do have these local democracy reporters, but people, when you don't have, particularly at a local level, you don't have, you know, officials and councillors, etc., being held to account, then that's when bad things can sometimes happen.
Yeah, it's. I don't think government should be involved in any sort of newspaper or supporting anyone, because you've got this thing with the big nationals, X amount cover Conservatives, X amount cover the Labour, and, you know, and they all go for their own support for different parties. I don't think you're going to find newspapers are going to be completely independent.
Yeah,
not even the Independent.
Yeah, in my age, you know, back in the day, people said there wouldn't be a newspaper. We wouldn't really have national newspapers in the shops. I mean, we barely lost any newspapers. I think the Independent, the Eye went online. The Today newspaper went bust, 1997. But really, we've still got a full complement of newspapers. You know, 10 odd kind of daily titles. That's unlike any other country, isn't it? It's very unusual for quite a small country to have many national titles. Is that sustainable?
Yeah, you've got, obviously it must be, but it relies on either very wealthy owners to keep showing, a bit like a football club, shoring up the club or shoring up the newspapers, and also at the same time, advertising.
Yeah.
Now, getting advertising, I think, is going to be so, so difficult. And certainly at these times when people are reluctant to advertise because they're not sure whether they're going to be in business next week.
Yeah.
You know, could there be a sudden lockdown again? No customers coming in. Yeah. Get rid of your staff. Why spend all that money on advertising, which can't be recouped?
Yeah, exactly. Okay, so that's the newspaper show. If you look in your local schedule, you'll see myself and Mike going through the local and national newspapers. So join us for that.